Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope, can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment.
Wait.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should have known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right. Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes, he fought with other kids who called me a, you know. In his own way, I think he understood what was going on. You want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks. He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left.
How did your son disappear? No point in pushing it. She's not going to tell me anymore. I didn't learn squat. Well, it's worth a try. I'll leave my card on the kitchen table. You never know. Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
Open up, baby. It's me.
What are you doing here? I already told you I don't want to see you anymore.
Sorry, Del, but I really wanted to see you. What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser. Again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. Again, asshole.
Are you all right?
Better than him, I guess. Who is he?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
Well, you should be careful. He'll probably be back. Sorry about the mess.
Mr. Shelby?
Yeah.
Thanks.
zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks. Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning, they told me to be here.
Now if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself, thank you.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the organic killer.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything.
Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over to see him with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it.
Tony! I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
The case seems to be attracting the attention of the media.
Yeah, a greedy pack of vultures. These guys have killed their mothers for a scoop. Some investigation. It's becoming a three-ring circus.
Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden, come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Harry comment. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Harry comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Comment. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet. Harry, coming. Orchid pollen detected. Probably from the flower left on the body.
I'm heading back to the office. You staying?
Yeah. I'm gonna have another look around if you don't mind.
Take all the time you want.
Harry, comment. The pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail. Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers. traces of blood on the fence behind the railroad line. It comes from the victim. The killer came this way with the body and probably grazed it on his way through the fence. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry, come in. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car.
I think I've seen all there is to see.
A bat. A fox. A crab. Death. Death.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident, Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's really unhappy. He just can't understand why I seem unable to love him.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
Have there been any cases of split personality developing after concussion? Like people doing things but having no memory of what they've done. Like somebody else had been doing them.
We know that in certain cases, a violent shock to the brain can cause serious psychological disturbances, like schizophrenia, for example. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Do you want to eat something? How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? A boomerang? You know how to use it?
No, not really. I can never make it come back.
Can I give it a try?
You did it, Dad!
Do you want to give it a try?
I won't be able to do it.
Oh, come on, let's try together. Now, the main thing is to get the right position at the beginning. Now, you gotta throw it straight and a little to the right. Now, throw it!
Dad!
Good job, Sean! See? That wasn't so hard.
I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah. Come on, Dad, make me fly.
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great! Whoa, I think my head is spinning.
Good training for astronauts, though. Want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. That was cool.
I'd like a packet of strawberry flavored chewies, please. Thanks.
Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberries. Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
That's a dollar.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
Thank you.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. Oh, cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. We just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get them well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Not bad.
Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
As you get Perry's assistant to show me my office, I can't wait to get to work. Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Step one, change the office.
killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. A common species. That doesn't help much. Just one origami store in town. The orchid is a common species. It can be found at any flower shop. Victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. Go wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Marsh. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... ...5:15, I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A brown coat. And a pair of pants. Black pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I went for a short walk around the park, just for a few minutes. When I got back, the carousel had stopped, and Sean wasn't there.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I don't know. I panicked. I didn't know what to do.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
That. You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to